This is a smart player. That's it.
Indeed.
Nice break for the Blue Jackets. They don't know how to celebrate on that one. They don't even know who scored the goal. But they'll take it. I don't know if Gagne touches this puck. He doesn't. I don't know who gets the goal.
Gagne, I think, took the face off. We'll wait for it officially, though.
Log in the puck. Whoa. Look out! No! Louis Erickson has put it into his own net.
Wow.
On him.
They just get on him, they get on him, and eventually that little stick in there lodges it loose. He tries to throw it back to Gudbranson right into the wide open net. As Miller had gone to the bench for the extra attacker, trying to prolong that extra man advantage, and it backfires on him with the first goal of the game on the delayed penalty.
Wow. Stands his ground with big Andrew Shaw in front.
Good whack in front too. I think he's going to go to get a penalty for it.
A broken stick by Sharp. The net empty for the Chicago Blackhawks. It's coming back. Could it go in? Yes, it's in! A goal! Ranta goes to the bench, and it's an own goal that ties this game at two.
What a smart play by Arcabello. Doesn't go for the puck, the little pick, the moving pick by him to not allow anybody to get back. Not that they were gonna. I don't think in time. You don't see this too often where it's played back off the boards by Patrick Kane, and this one just has eyes for the net. Watch Arcabello take a look. He goes, hey, this is going in, and he sees the player coming off the bench. Just a little moving pick.
Flow with the puck. On the boards, trying to get away. Shoots. Blocker save made by Anderson. And yep, a little flip out to center ice, picked up by Gagliardi. He makes the pass ahead for O'Reilly, but will angle too far. Murray will put it in the corner. Put goes to pass it behind the net. Boyle went to go behind the net. Now he could have this. He doesn't shoot this directly in, does he, Mike?
Here's the player. Oh. Get another look at that and see how that puck went in. The Avalanche, though, win it 1-0 and lead the series 2-1. Overtime win.
And now it's
left, though. Great week of hockey. Burns shoots. Kincaid save. Burns rebound. And they score. It looked like Kyle Quincy ended up putting it into his own net.
Watch this glove save, but he can't hold it. Look at the little inside out by Burns. Tries to go far side. And yeah, you're right. That is Kyle Quincy. That's skate talking into your own net.
Things that give you an advantage, kind of that intangible side of the ledger. And Kelly brought it up. There's holes in his game. You even watch tonight where Hammond's been moving left and the puck's gone right. Look at that tricky little bounce that you just saw.
Oh, and there's a terrible bounce. Markov misplayed it.
Into his own net.
Oh, my goodness.
It's just a dump. Catches a carom. Carey Price not sure what to do. Watch Markov's stick right there. He puts it right between Carey Price's legs. PK Subban takes advantage of that past the net, and Markov just gets lost.
Colbert now. Trying to get it around Lucas Biza. And a penalty coming up against the Biza as he trips up Colbert. Colbert back and forth, down low, out of the corner to Weidman, and he drifts one all the way down.
Uh-oh,
look at that! This is going to the net! The Calgary Flames put one in their own net!
There's the penalty on Biza with the hook down below, but more importantly, Dennis Weidman tries to go D-to-D, catches Raymond in a bad spot, and my goodness. If you're Calgary, you're thinking, are you kidding me? Could this possibly happen to us?
In front of the net, Cronwall shooting, rebound, scores! Zetterberg in front of the net! This game's all tied 2-2! Power play goal, Petrie put it in his own net!
Wow. Wow.
close look at this. Edinburgh protects the puck to Datsyuk. Cronwall lets it go. Oh my goodness, you trying to find a hole to hide in and look at Petrie. Oh, Dad, I didn't mean to do it. Oh my God. One of those things, we've all done it.
Seam pass cut off, look out, Plekanec it's loose. What a quick take of pass, in, and Anderson points in. Bob Cowan, and Plekanec has tied it on a own goal, and Jared Cowan's reaction speaks volumes.
Beside Cowan when he makes the pass, he cannot let Plekanec get between him and the Ottawa net. Plekanec gets in the clear, his second breakaway of the night. He scored shorthanded in the first period. This time Anderson closes it down and hits the right skate of Jared Cowan.
And meanwhile, this is brought to you.
Sorry, Doc. Bad giveaway there by Colton Parayko. Almost put it right on a tee for the Blackhawks to walk right down the slot. Hawks were not able to cash in. Look out.
Oh, a giveaway and it goes into the net. The Blackhawks put one in their own cage.
Let's see. Brodziak just swats away at Seabrook, and the puck goes in off of Duncan Keith. He might be right, Eddie and Doc. Right here, Brodziak.
Did he touch?
I think he just hit the stick. Yeah, I don't think he ever touched the puck.
I don't think he touched the puck either.
It's going to be the blue that
times. Ryan Nugent-Hopkins, Benoit Pouliot, Taylor Hall, Connor McDavid, they score.
Oh.
Right off the hop, the Oilers get their first goal of the season. And it's a power play marker.
They want shots on the power play as quickly as possible. But this one isn't a shot. It's a bank off of Benoit Pouliot. A lost draw, a clear attempt, and the shot goes off the Blues, from the Blues, off the Blues in the net.
Alex Steen, an own goal.
Kovalchuk. Zajac goes to the bench. And a pass for Adam Henrique is off the mark and unbelievably into the Devils' goal.
It's been thrashed around behind the net. I don't think that top cane touches it with his stick. But if we can take it back a little farther, guys, we'll see who touched it. Oh, maybe Brandon Sutter. Maybe he did touch it. Let's make sure. I don't want to say that was an errant pass.
Behind him, and Eller will shovel it back down the ice.
That's an example of where Henrik has to be more selfish and shoot that puck at the net.
A puck comes in front, into the skates, and in the net! Oh, an own goal by the Canucks! Oh my goodness!
One of the strangest goals you'll ever see in hockey.
All the Canadians were at their bench making a change.
Garrison gets it caught in the skates of Garrison. Roberto, of course, not following the puck, and wow, I don't know if I've ever seen one quite that odd, and I've seen a lot of strange goals go in.
Upcoming against Washington, good move by Wasilchuk. Lalime plays it outside the line, and he scores on his own goal! Incredibly, Nick Lalime sends it back. Ward had left on a delayed whistle, and that counts for Washington. Oh, Nick Lalime looks for a place to hide.
Oh, wow. John, you and I have been working together for 6 years. I don't think we've ever seen this, and you have to feel badly for Vallin right now. A delayed penalty. Ward had obviously gone to the bench for the extra attacker, and let's see if it's the stick work of Washington playing through to the whistle. And I'm not sure exactly what Nick was trying to do with it. Just slid off his stick. I don't know who he was trying to find with that pass.
Centering pass, gloved out of midair by Bergevin. How long did he have that puck in his glove? Now the puck's in the net.
Puck just kind of crosses in front.
Oh my goodness, that's easily in the net. But the question is, how did it get there? There's Bergevin. That's where I thought he had it. Oh, he did.
He did. He threw it right in his own goal.
He threw it in his own net.
There by Ablocator, and a good shot.
Oh,
scores!
Oh my goodness.
Their own man.
Oh, he drilled it in his own net.
Miller let the shot go, and the Blues put it in their own goal.
To knock the puck into the corner, up over the net. Look at this. Oh my goodness, after all those great stops, that one's going to be on the highlight reels at 11:30 tonight. Oh, it was.